Probably this one for me.
The reason we like Mexico City the most is because we've had really wonderful shows here. And since the very first time we've come here, the fans have just showed us that they really do like care about us and love us. And it's not everywhere you go where you feel that way. So, you know, Mexico City's always been a place we look forward to go to. Even living in New York, Mexicans that I would meet were always just a little bit kinder and sweeter than other people. And so when we come here, we really see that a lot. That's the main difference for me. But I think we all share the same fears and the, you know, the same dreams and the same anxiety. And I mean, I just like tacos, you know, simple stuff. Simple, like, little tofu taco or something.
I don't know. Is ceviche, like, a Mexican thing? Did that originate here? Oh, I'm so sorry.
They do have good...
You do a good job of it here, though.
We just had some today.
How can I just pick one? I guess just, like, dying, probably. Yeah. Dying. All the different ways I could die. I think it's a very uncertain thing. I don't think anyone can know what happens after you die. The most obvious, logical thing to think is that nothing happens, which is what I am afraid of.
You experience the same sensations as, you know, you did before you were born, which is nothing unpleasant, but, you know, it's just nothing. And mine was adopting two shelter dogs 2 years ago. They both have the same name, and it's just Cow.
Cow, why
is that? Because they both just lay around like cows. I want to go to Maine, the state of Maine. I've always wanted to go. I live a few states away. And it's ridiculous that I haven't gotten there. It seems like all my dreams would come true if I just went to Maine.
That's how I felt about Vermont when I went there, and it was true.
Did your dreams come true?
Yeah. Going back there, too, this winter. For me, probably Greenland. Probably, like, the Wonder Years.
I think I like Freaks and Geeks.
It's very similar to the Wonder Years.
It's the same thing.
I don't know if they necessarily define a person. I think that we're very interested in colors and all that sort of thing. It's probably more less about a literal definition of yourself and more like a how you view yourself or how you want to represent yourself.
This is the Mayan calendar, I believe. It was a gift from a fan. We just did a signing.
We signed stuff. Yeah, a fan gave us this. We don't really know anything about it other than it's quite lovely. I think it is such a blessing, and the one true comfort we have in this life.
I agree, yeah. I have a hard time making friends. And once I make some, I have a hard time keeping them. But there are a few, like four, that have like somehow stayed with me, and I've stayed with them. So it's nice to kind of keep a small group and not try to be the big guy in town who knows everyone. It's kind of, I've tried that before and it left me really frustrated. So if you can find people that love you for who you are, and all of you and all that you are, and who make you feel loved and accepted, those are the people you want to keep close, you know.
Here. Oh. It makes me think of, like, you know, like raindrops or something.
Raindrops, yeah.
Raindrops.
It just makes me think of my childhood best friend and how he left in the second grade and went to Oaxaca and lived there for 7 years. I really missed him. And when he came back, things weren't the same. You know, I had grown up.
Things change, people change.
I was like 9 years old. I had my whole life going.